Please be seated. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the celebration of Molly and Josh's wedding. My name is Bill Flaherty. I am Josh and soon-to-be Molly's brother-in-law. Before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge that both Josh and Molly have loved ones who couldn't be here with us today. Let's all please take a moment in silence in remembrance of them. Thank you. Now, a long time ago, in a classroom far, far away, two little eighth graders, one of whom I'm pretty sure was still in braces, met at Nashua Catholic and set us on the path to being here today. Though they could not have known it then, it was the beginning of a long friendship and eventually a deep love and bond. As they say, love finds a way. Josh and Molly, you've had a lot of adventures together. Today does not mark the beginning of a new adventure, but rather a promise to stand beside each other for all of the adventures to come. Our wish for you is that those adventures will lead to ever and ever greater happiness. Now, I'd like to invite Kim up for the first reading.
An Uncommon Love by Tara Cox. May you have the love only two can know. May you go where only two as one may go. May the sun rise and set in your bonded hearts, and the moon never find you too long apart. May you cherish each other's dreams as your own and turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. May you brave life's mountains and miles together. May there be no storm your love cannot weather. May you be lovers and allies and friends. May your soul's conversation never end. May you capture on earth what's in heaven above. May your hearts know the rapture of an uncommon love.
Thank you, Kim. Now I'd like to invite Brad up for our second reading.
Love is an adventure. Love is an adventure and a conquest. It survives and develops like the universe itself, only by perpetual discovery. The only right love is that between couples whose passion leads them both, one through the other, to a higher possession of their being. Put your faith in the spirit which dwells between the two of you. You have each offered yourself to other as a boundless field of understanding, of enrichment, of mutually increased sensibility. You will meet above all by entering into and constantly sharing one another's thoughts, affections, and dreams. There alone, as you know, in spirit, which is arrived through flesh, you will find no disappointments, no limits. There alone, the skies are ever open for your love. There alone lies the great road ahead.
Thank you, Brad. Now, a large part of Josh and Molly's relationship has always been the outdoors. Hikes, camping trips, skiing, and all sorts of other adventures together. Because of this, they thought the tree behind me was the perfect symbol of their love. It starts from a small seed, but over the years grows large and beautiful. In order for that transformation to take place, the tree requires both soil and water. Now I'd like to invite the couple's parents up to the gazebo. As many of you may know, both Josh and Molly's parents still live in the house where their children grew up. I'd first like to ask the fathers to come forward and add soil to the base of the tree from those houses. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Now, I'd like to ask their mothers to come forward and add water to the tree from both of their houses as well. Thank you very much, ladies. The elements that the parents have added represent the stability and sense of family they have imparted in their children, which will help strengthen their marriage from this day forward. On one final note, there will be times during your marriage where you will be apart. One thing this tree will always make sure is true is that you'll always be pining for each other.
That's good.
Now for the vows. Josh and Molly, the vows you speak here today represent the promises you will keep for the rest of your lives. Josh, please repeat after me. I, Josh, take you, Molly, to be my wife and best friend.
I, Josh, take you, Molly, to be my wife and best friend.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you through all of our adventures in life together.
I will love you and honor you throughout our adventures in life together.
Molly, repeat after me. I, Molly, take you, Josh, to be my husband and best friend.
I, Molly, take you, Josh, to be my husband and best friend.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you through all of our adventures in life together.
I will love you and honor you in all our adventures in life together.
Perfect. Okay, and now we will exchange rings. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other, and always remind you of your love. Now, Josh, please place Molly's ring on her finger and repeat after me. Molly, take and wear this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Molly, take and wear this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Molly, please place Josh's ring on his finger and repeat after me. Josh, take and wear this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Josh, take and wear this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Now, by the power invested in me by the state of New Hampshire, I pronounce you husband and wife. Josh, you may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Valley.